Leading the news today, the Prime Minister has set an ambitious goal to reopen Australia by July. Scott Morrison is pushing the states to ease their COVID restrictions on social and business life. He's blamed school closures and bans on public gatherings for some of the worst damage to the economy. New guidelines are being rolled out for workplaces to reopen, including staggered start times and an end to hot desking. Concerns about virus clusters are growing after outbreaks at a Melbourne abattoir and Sydney's Newmarch nursing home. The Qantas Group has flagged $19 airfares between Sydney and Melbourne and $89 from Perth to Sydney to help tourism recover. And Microsoft founder Bill Gates has donated $10 million to a Melbourne trial of a vaccine typically used against tuberculosis. The UK has reported the highest death toll in Europe as the global toll passes 250,000. Around Australia, there have been 26 new infections reported in the past day. There are 6,849 confirmed cases. The death toll has increased by 1 to 97. 5,890 people have recovered, up by 30. New South Wales has 3,035 cases from more than 250,000 tests. In Victoria, there are 1,423 cases, a rise of 17 infections. Queensland has 1,043 cases, with 57 still active. Western Australia still has 551 cases for a sixth straight day. South Australia has reached no new cases for the 13th straight day in a row, with just 5 active cases. Tasmania has 223 cases, with 2 new infections in the state's north. There are 107 in the ACT, with 1 active case. The Northern Territory has 29 cases from nearly 5,000 tests. And the COVID-safe app has been downloaded more than 5 million times. Live now to our team of reporters, first to Taylor Aiken in Canberra. Taylor, Scott Morrison says virus restrictions are costing this country billions of dollars.
Good morning, Nat. That's right. And yes, the cost the Prime Minister says is just too much for Australia to bear going forward. Having flattened the coronavirus infection curve, Prime Minister Morrison says Australians must now work to flatten the curve of rising unemployment. The National Cabinet is working to finalise a timeline for a further easing of restrictions on Friday, believing the benefits to business now outweigh the risk to public health. And while there will be a national framework approach detailing what restrictions will be eased first, it will be up to individual states and territories to decide when to implement those changes, and that's due to a different rate of infection in each jurisdiction. The Prime Minister adding that he accepts there will be a rise in infections once movement within the community increases, but he's confident there are strong protocols now in place in order to contain any outbreaks and not put any unnecessary pressure on our public health system.
David Woywood is in Melbourne this morning. David, the government's introduced some new workplace guidelines.
Yes, Nat, this is all part of the Prime Minister's push to create, as he is now terming them, COVID-safe businesses. A new website has been created with that industry-specific information. It has guidelines for businesses to kickstart their operations in the safest way possible. Now, it includes information on things like improved hygiene in workplaces, temperature testing where appropriate, staggered start times and meal breaks for employees to try and limit that exposure, as well as protective equipment and no hot desking, the end of hot desking in Australia. Now, broadly speaking, workers groups and unions, they have been supportive of this plan, but they would like to see some more detail.
We need to have regulations, new regulations that deal with a pandemic that are consistently in place across Australia, so employers know what they have to do and workers know what's needed to keep them safe.
Yes, it will be hard for some businesses to adapt as well. Take just one example here in Victoria, Cedar Meats in Melbourne's West. It has now been linked to more than 40 cases of coronavirus in the past few weeks. So a lot of work for that company to do, but this will be a monumental shift for businesses right across the country, Nat.
Samantha Brett is at the overseas passenger terminal in Sydney today. Sam, a senior New South Wales health officer, has apologised for her department's handling of the Ruby Princess situation.
Yeah, that's right, Nat. That is senior epidemiologist Kellyanne Ressler. Yesterday, she faced certainly some very harsh questioning at that inquiry into the Ruby Princess debacle. Even though she wasn't directly involved, she did give an apology. Here's some of what she had to say.
Commissioner, all I can say is that I'm very sorry it turned out the way it did. It was not our intention. Myself and my colleagues at the Public Health Unit were working very hard on this. We did what we could. And if we could do it again, it would be very different.
Now, this, of course, is an investigation into how exactly 2,700 passengers were allowed to disembark from the Ruby Princess on March 19. That led to 21 people dying and more than 700 cases of COVID-19. The big revelation yesterday was that, well, we already knew that not enough people were tested, but now we are being told that the people who were tested, their results weren't a priority, so they were able to walk around in the community without knowing that they were infected for way too long. And the other thing that we learned was that a logbook that was given to New South Wales Health, that was out of date. That was supposed to tell the department exactly how many people were sick on board. That inquiry in Sydney continues today, Nat.
OK, thanks to our team of reporters there. The PM has received a special phone call from the Queen. Her Majesty rang to check in on Australia's progress dealing with coronavirus as well as our bushfire recovery. But she also wanted to know about the horses. The royal racing enthusiast was glad to hear our tracks are still open.